Brandon, we'll make it out of the CCM Cafe today with our friends, the Erwins. How are you?
Hey, doing great, Brandon. How about you, man?
Good. So you're in Nashville this week promoting the new album, Life Story. It's out there now, and now it's been out there a few weeks. What do you hope people are pulling out of this one?
God has given us some powerful songs, and we actually haven't even staged all of them yet. We had to bus in the mechanic shop for a month, and so it kind of delayed some of our practice time. We've got a couple that we haven't done yet, but we've done most of them, and I'm telling you, by the grace of God, there have been some great reviews, and it's really helped people. Songs like None But Jesus and Back to the Garden and have really helped people, and praise the Lord for giving us these songs from some incredible writers.
Yeah.
And so it's been a 3-year journey for us since our last new album. So it was time, and we were ready to sing some new material. So thank you for having us here, Brandon.
Yeah,
appreciate you guys.
Some of those songwriters, if people know Jesus music, they're going to recognize the names.
Yeah. Exactly right.
Talk about some of those folks you collaborated this time.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah. Ken West, Jason Cox, Jason Crabb.
Michael Farron,
Charity Gale, and Ryan Kennedy co-wrote a song.
Jaron Davis.
Yeah.
Incredible. Writing many more.
Yeah. We got to co-write again together.
That's right.
We did some writing together.
And we're doing that more and more.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I believe that's kind of a new venture that probably will be done more so as we go.
Yeah, so 9 songs made the cut this time?
That's right.
9 songs.
Exactly.
So I'm sure there was a lot more that were wrote in those sessions. How did you narrow it down to 9? And is there going to be a deluxe edition coming soon with these other songs?
That's the perk of starting to write our own music. You know, we can keep that on hold for however long we want. So who knows? You know, unless we decide to share it to another artist, which we might do one day. But we also have some that we are super excited about for albums in the future.
Yeah, and as Keith was saying, you know, it's an incredible issue, a problem to have such great material that God gives us, whether it be through friends or through songs that he gives us. It's an incredible problem that you have to put your own songs on hold, you know, just because you have such great songs that we really believe that God wanted that place in our ministry in this moment to share.
And we never heard that many demos.
Yeah.
For a
3-year
time, we probably listened to 1,000 songs.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Because we loved listening to them. We were telling every writer to bring as many as they could, and they just kept emailing them. And it was a lot of songs to not only listen to, but to choose between. And like you said, it was hard for us to make that decision, but thankfully we made it.
Yeah. So the Southern Gospel crowd, they know who the Erwins are. But people that may be listening to CCM Radio, they may be looking at this, hearing us talk, like they should know you.
Yeah.
They don't. Let's give them the life story of the Erwins for somebody who has never seen these faces before.
Yeah, so our dad started this ministry 50 years ago, this coming June. This year will be 50 years for him. Traveled by himself for 17 years as a single evangelist. And he didn't get married until he was 38. Got married at First Baptist Dallas. Dr. Crystal married our parents. And this is all we've ever done, traveling the roads. Literally, we were in a van the first 12 years of my life. And since then, 2005, I think, something like that, we've been in a bus for almost 20 years.
You're all very homeschooled, And we grew up on the road. As Keith said, us three boys sang a lot together, you know, before Dad would preach at different churches across the country. And then God just opened up doors from there, specifically when we added Katie.
Once they added me,
I think that was just a coincidence.
When we added Katie to the group, just because it was inevitable. She was the younger sister coming on, and she was singing. It was better than we were at the time, so we added her over the group.
Speak for yourself.
Yeah. ever since then, though, it's honestly been an amazing journey with siblings together. Some of our favorite artists in Christian music have been sibling
or
groups.
Family groups, the kingdom came. And we can go down the list.
Absolutely.
There's so many.
So to be doing that in our own way and to see how God did it so naturally, as far as, you know, our parents were forced us to sing. We just were raised in church, so we were then raised around the music. So that really birthed the love for Christian music in our hearts. And the fact that we get to do it now together, it's an incredible thing.
And with this being CCM, I mean, we were raised listening to Stephen Curtis Chapman,
Michael W. Smith,
Phillips Craig and Dean. I think the best vocal group.
Oh my goodness,
Avalon. Yes. And then we would go to Inspirations. We would go. I mean,
Jeff and Cherry Easter,
Mid South Boys. If any of you guys remember Mid South, but we have a kind of a wide array of music that we were raised on, and we believe that's healthy. And we thank God that our parents exposed us to that wide genre.
And I think it influenced some in our music, even some of the writings. You get so many different flavors, and some sound like this, some sound like that.
And when you think about it, that's what the church is.
Yeah.
You know, it's all genres together anyway. I mean, when you worship Christ, the church represents all ages. It represents so many different backgrounds of always alive, so that we get to come together. And with this album, we try to do an album with songs for the church. We try to do songs whether you can sing along to them, or just, we wanted to make songs for the church, because no matter what, we've learned even the last 4 years or so, the church will always be there.
Sure.
So that's something we really wanted to do with this album.
Yeah, so all these years, it's been just the four of you, and then you bring Katie on, and now Katie's brought on at least a part-time fifth member.
Yes! My husband, Logan Hedrick, is actually the fifth one on the album cover. He's the handsome one with the beard. But we've been married almost 2 years. October of 2022 is when we got married. We're having a blast. He's an ICU nurse, so he doesn't get to travel all the time. But when he does, we put him to work either running sound or playing guitar. So
that's why he's not here today. He's
that's
in the hospital
why he's
today.
Not here. Yeah. Yes, we had a great friend come in and play guitar for us today. But yes, I love being married to him. He's the best.
Was there pressure when you're looking for your husband? He's gonna be the group, and his name doesn't start with a K.
We call him Hogan.
That's right.
Talking about the K's, you got the new podcast has been out there for a few months.
Right. Thank you for mentioning that. Yeah, four K's in a pod.
It's fun.
It's fun. It's tragic, but it's fun.
It is so lighthearted.
It's silly.
We like it to be like you are sitting on the bus with us after a concert.
Exactly,
and
right.
We like to introduce some of our friends, a lot of songwriters. Our producer actually had an episode, Wayne Vaughn.
Yeah.
Our parents have been on there.
Yeah.
So it's been a lot of fun. We're kind of hitting a lot of different avenues with it. So we hope you all enjoy it. You can listen on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, or YouTube. You search the Erwins.
Four K's in a pod.
That's right.
I told you we were homeschooled.
It's a lot of fun.
So this has been your entire life, this family band. Do you even know what the pros and cons of being in a family band are? Or is this just your entire life? You get to pick out pros and cons.
That's a good question.
Should you?
No, I don't know. Because we don't have anything to relate it to. This is all we've ever done.
We can only empathize.
Yeah, I mean,
it's one of those things where the road life is not for the faint of heart. Those who have done it at any capacity know it's not easy. So with that being said, I couldn't imagine the long hours away from home without bringing home with you.
Yeah, home feels like home.
Yeah.
Because you're with your family. And so some
days.
It's
easier.
Yes, it's a pro. That's, I guess, a pro and a con.
Yeah.
Because some days we just want to close our bum.
And never see each other.
That's why I say it's a pro and a con.
Because we know each other so well that instead of, you know, we know when to close the curtain. We know when to,
We are real siblings. We are normal siblings.
And luckily, you've been at a long enough to where you have that bus with a curtain and you're not, you're not in a church fan.
Well, like I said, our bus just got out of the shop. So the whole month of February, we were without our bus, and we were just in a car doing dates all month. And I think we quit two or three times.
We were joking earlier, this is our reunion tour.
That's right.
We got a new album.
That's right. But thankfully, we got the bus back, and all is well. So,
we're having fun.
Yeah.
All right, great seeing you guys again. The Life Story is out there streaming now, so download it, put it on all your playlists. And tour is still happening too, right?
That's right.
Yes, go to erwinministries.com to look at all of our tour dates, and be sure to follow us on social media, Facebook, X, and Instagram under the Erwins.
That's right.